Well, howdy, 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 folks. It is a beautiful spring day. Look at that. I'm talking not a tree with a leaf yet, but we're getting there. I think spring has sprung, except for those of you in the Midwest. Just read today on the news that the Midwest is expecting up to 30 inches of snow, some kind of rare freak blizzard. I think that's your ninth for the week or something. Of course, everywhere is getting this weird weather. I mean, it's just nuts, right? So I want to welcome you, and I want to talk about commissaries. It scares the hell out of people all the time that are starting. It's probably one of my top 10 most asked, you know, calls where they, oh, Ben, my state is saying this, or I got to have a commercial kitchen. Well, yeah, I teach that in the free training and how to do it and how to get them free. Okay. But some states are a pain in the butt. Some states require all kinds of stuff. But what I'm going to cover today is I'm going to cover how to do a commissary cheap, on the fly. I'm going to talk about the profit potential in a commissary for you, extra profit. Okay. I'm going to talk about why you need a commissary, why states require it. I'm going to talk about how some vendors get away without having a commissary. I'm also going to talk about about shared incubator commissaries, okay, which is shared kitchens. And I'm also going to talk about the ability to use churches and stuff like that. So let me get right to it. So before I go to the comments and get all sidetracked, y'all will have me squirreled into crazy land trying to figure out what to answer, because I'll see one question and it'll sidetrack me. So I'll come back to your questions if you have any towards the end. But let me explain commissaries as best I can. I'm outside today. It is beautiful. And I'm fixing to do one of our members in the Vendors United sent me his, he was a pro barbecuer, you know, went on that barbecue tour thing for years. And he gave me his recipe. He gave us all in Vendors United his recipe for the beef brisket. Well, he gave us his whole cookbook. But I'm taking the beef brisket, and I've been doing exactly like he said so that I can make the best beef brisket in the world, okay? And it's coming. It's been marinating for over 18 hours, and now it's going to go on my grill here in a minute. My grill is right there. That's a Rectech down by the river. And it is, here, I'll show you this real quick. This is unprofessional as heck, but you see the river? And there's my wife trying to smoke me out with the fire pit right behind me. And, it's just beautiful. So anyway, I'm excited to be here. I'm excited to be outside today. I can't even tell you. I'm like a, you know, kid in a candy store today with the weather. And so let me talk about the commissaries. I'm going to go through this quick, and I'm going to talk fast, and you might have questions, but I'm going to help you out with those questions, because all of this is on the blog at learnhotdogs.com, but I'm going to try to cover everything at once in one fell swoop on commissaries. First, what is a commissary? Well, it's a crazy French word that means commercial kitchen, okay? I don't know that for a fact. I just made that up. So commissary is what they call it. You've heard of it. If you've been in the military, you know what a commissary is, right? So a commissary is a kitchen. It is a commercial kitchen. Why would a vendor need one? Why do all 50 states require one? Because they say that if you have pans and stuff that you need to wash, well, you need a place to wash them. And you need a place to serve, to prep food, to cut onions, to make your Coca-Cola onions. You need a place to store food, store dry food and cold storage. And they don't want that to be at your house, because they don't want your six dogs and three cats' hairs all over the food that you're going to be serving to the public. So most states will not allow you to have a commissary at your house, except some do. There are some exceptions to that rule. They make these little exceptions. Here's some of the exceptions you might hear. If you just ask, all you have to do is ask your health inspector. You go, hey, can I put a commissary at my house? And they'll go, well, do you have a separate entrance to it? Like here, it's a separate entrance. That's the requirement. And is there access from any pets? Well, I have the separate entrance down, but you got me at pets, because we have a Gilligan. That's a cat. And Gilligan goes anywhere he wants. Well, that ruled me out of a commissary. So what did I do? I built a commissary. But before I talk about that, and that's the purpose of all this is today, is the commissary. But before I talk about building a commissary on the fly and on the cheap, I'm going to give you all the other ways that are quick and easy too. Okay? I'm going to even talk about how I built my commissary. But I want you to understand, I'm smoking today through this, okay? I get hyped up, and then I don't take pauses, and I forget to breathe, and then I'll pass out, and somebody will get hurt, right? Probably me. So anyway, I want to talk to you about the other ways to get a commissary, and I should have written myself notes for this, but I'm trying to wing this off the top of my head. There are multiple ways. I like the free ways, and I teach this. If you just remember this, if you go to learnhotdogs.com, I'm going to get rid of this real quick. If you go to learnhotdogs.com, okay, and you just type in the word commissary, okay, it's commissary, commissary. If you need to spell that, it's right there, okay? So, commissary. So, how do you like that? Graphics. That's my team of me doing that, those bottom graphics for you. So, anyway, if you need to find out information on getting a free commissary, I got the pitch for you. I got the whole thing. When I say pitch, what you need to say to get a free commissary. Now, when I first started, I just went to a buddy who had a barbecue restaurant, Clint's Barbecue, and I said, hey, Clint, I called him up because I already knew him. And I said, listen, state is requiring me to have a commissary. You probably won't ever see me. But can I have you sign a letter saying that I'm allowed to use your commercial kitchen? And he goes, no problem. And I dropped by his barbecue place, and he signed this little letter. If you need the letter, it's also free at learnhotdogs.com. Just look up commissary letter and download it. It's just a simple letter, okay? And then give that to your health department. That's what I did. Now, there's other ways to get it. Now, you probably have Shriners, and you probably have the VA groups like Veterans of Foreign Wars, VFW places, and all those different little groups and clubs around your town. Those groups have a commissary. They have a kitchen. And they're a licensed kitchen for most parts. Some states even license a kitchen if it's in a church. And many churches have a kitchen. And it's a commercial kitchen because it's not for family use. It's for public use, right? So public being the church. But you can often ask your church, you can ask your preacher, preacher, I need a commissary. I need to be able to say that I come here and clean my pans, or that I can have the ability to. And he signs the letter and you're good to go. Now you have a free commissary. Now, a lot of vendors are scared of this. They're like, oh my gosh, I don't want to do that. I'm going to just call people. Well, don't. Save yourself the time and trouble, because when calling people, you will not get a commissary unless you've got a friend like Clint, who has a barbecue restaurant, and he'll answer the phone and give you a yes. But other than that, you need to go to people in person. A great place to go is to little mom and pop restaurants or grills at the gas station. The gas station has a grill, right? You know, they serve whatever, your biscuits and gravy in the morning, or they sell subs in the afternoon. Well, their kitchen is considered a commissary. So you can ask them, say, listen, I'm a small vendor. Me and my wife are doing this to feed the kids and get off food stamps. And I'm just kidding. And you downplay it, but you go in and you ask permission. And most of them will give you permission. But a lot of vendors don't. They're scared to death of asking for help. They're like, oh my gosh, I can't even imagine asking somebody to use their kitchen. I don't know anybody with a restaurant. That whole thing scares me, and I go, okay, here's a solution. I have a video called A New Way to Get a Commissary, and it's a video right here on YouTube. And all it comes down to, and it's in the Fatter Me. You'll see the Fatter Me doing that video. And in that video, it has a I give you what's called incubator kitchens, okay, or shared kitchens. If you use the Googles, okay, if you use Google and search commissary kitchen or shared kitchen in my area, you will pull up commissary kitchens, especially if you live near or around any big town. Okay, there will be some vendors now are doing it themselves. More on that in a minute, but my point is you can rent space or time in a kitchen, a commercial kitchen, then sign off. So Georgia, being the asshats of the week, okay, is is in their efforts to restrict vendors, in their efforts to restrict things for vendors, they've said in their code, they actually say this in their code, your commissary must be owned and not shared. But they do allow shared kitchens. But they don't allow you to go to your church or to your daycare center. A lot of daycares have a commercial kitchen. They don't allow you to go to your VFW. They don't allow it. Now, why? I have no idea. Now, here's before you give up and go, oh, my God, I'm in Georgia. Don't give up, okay, because I got solutions for you. And one of them is all counties ain't the same. The state has the code, but each county kind of, you know, does their own thing. And which is great when it works in your favor. It's not so good when they make up, oh, you need pink umbrellas. We only allow pink umbrellas in town. And then you have to go, listen, your code doesn't say that. But if you have a commissary requirement like Georgia, which you won't unless you're in Georgia, don't give up. Go to your county inspector and ask. Go, hey, I found a commissary at my local church. Are they registered? Or my local daycare, they said I could use it. Or my local VFW, they said I could use their kitchen. And they may go, sure, that's fine. That's great. Awesome. Can you get them to sign a letter? Sure, no problem. I got it from learnhotdogs.com. They give you a free letter because that hillbilly knows what he's talking about. So that gives you an in. So don't give up just because I told you the broad rule for Georgia, because not all inspectors are equal. Some are nice. Some are anal retentive egomaniacs. So don't worry about that. Now let's talk about what other options you have. One of the easy options, it costs a little more, but there's a plus to it, okay? It costs an investment, but then you make money. And I'm going to go into two of those, okay? So first, if you live in a town where there are dilapidated, closed down, been for sale for 900 years, restaurants, because they went out of business, you know, they had a fire, you know, I call them going out of fire sales, because furniture stores and restaurants are famous, or infamous, for having going out of business fire sales. Going out of business fires. So if you can find one of those, maybe you know of one now that you know, oh, Eagle Burt's Best Burgers in town, they've been closed down for 6 years. That building's been up for sale or lease forever. Nobody's using it. Call the realtor and go, listen, I'm a vendor. I have a requirement to have a commercial kitchen. Is it possible for me to lease that on a month-to-month basis? You don't have to go in there and fix that restaurant up. Just get the required stuff you need. Now, let's get to the required stuff. And this goes to option two, doing your own commissary, which was the reason for this video. See, it only took me how long now to get to the reason of my video? 13 minutes and 13 seconds. That's freaking awesome, right? I'm doing better than my average. So here's what you would do. You would go to make your own commissary. Now, I've had vendors do this out of mini storage units. A lot of mini storage units have water. Who would have guessed? And a floor drain. I don't know why, but some do. But if yours don't, it was just for those people that do. If yours don't, think about making your own. You can create your own commissary pretty easy. You can go buy a steel shed at Lowe's or Home Depot. You can ask your health inspector, say, listen, I want to just make my own commissary because I have 16 dogs and cats in my house and you're not going to let me use my kitchen. So what is the minimum I can get away with? And they'll go, well, it's only what you need. So we are going to require you have a wash, rinse, sanitize sink. Y'all have all seen those. I'm going to show you a picture. Here's some. These are little commissaries. Okay. This one, as long as they have three sinks, wash, rinse, sanitize, and a hand wash sink, they're good to go. This person obviously got away with less than that. This one, wash, rinse, sanitize sink. You see that sink there on the left? That's what I'm talking about. Now, this person may have needed a commercial stove and a hood system because they bake bread and they cook soups and all that stuff because they run a full-fledged catering business. I'm just giving you examples. You may only need wash, rinse, sanitize, a floor drain, and a hand wash sink. That's it. And most states, that's all you need. Now, if you tell them, I'm going to be also doing pizza, they're going to say, well, we're going to need to see that pizza oven in there because you ain't doing that at your house. And they'll go, and it doesn't mean if it's attached to your house, it could be in your yard. Okay. I had to have one inspected to go to my, cause I had a septic. I wasn't on city utilities. So it had to, they had to inspect my septic to see if it could handle the extra amount of water from me washing my chili pans. Right. So it doesn't, it's not that big a deal. I'm going to show you another one here if I can find it. There's a little one. There's a little tiny one, that's just used for, you know, they have a hood system, but they got a sink, they got a washer and sanitizer on the backside, and then they got a prep table. That's it. Okay. Now you don't have to have all this fancy stainless steel, because the food code, the standard for food service, is just non-porous items. Non-porous means I take a piece of wood. I wish I had one handy. I take a piece of wood. This picnic table I'm on, I'm going to show it to you. Okay, this picnic table, see, this piece of wood is porous, which means if I spill bacon grease on this piece of wood, it's going into the wood, which is a cause for bacteria. So that can cause me bacteria issues, whatever. So they don't allow that. But what if I polyurethane that wood? Now it's non-porous, and now it's food safe, according to FDA Chapter 4. So you're covered. You don't have to go get stainless steel. That's why people that build a cart from our Build a Cart course, it's buildacart.com. There's a plug, wink, wink. Buildacart.com, you can build your own cart. It's made out of wood. Now, yes, you can put a stainless steel top on it if you want. Great, it looks prettier. But you can, I've had many vendors just do it out of wood and polyurethane or food grade paint, a safe food based paint. You know, food, not food based paint. This paint's made from hot dogs. No, it's a, it's a food-safe paint, so something that's food-safe, some type of enamel paint, okay? You can use caulk for your cracks and stuff, any food-safe silicone, which is all silicone that's 100% silicone, and you can buy that now in different colors. So you can buy 100% silicone and fill cracks, divots, holes from wood, whatever, and now you've made that safe. So you don't have to go to the stainless steel. So let me list this again. Three bay sink, wash, rinse, sanitize. Okay. I need to bring up this real quick right after this. So hopefully I'll remember. So you got wash, rinse, sanitize, a hand wash sink. That's four sinks total, right? You need to have a prep area. Doesn't have to be stainless steel. And that's all typically they require. A mop sink sometimes. They'll say, oh, you need a mop sink. Well, I got a space that's 10 by 10. Why do I need to mop it? And they'll go, well, you need to mop it. And you go, can I use my other sink to dump the mop water into? And they go, no, we want a mop sink. Okay, so you add a mop sink, which is $78 on Amazon, and it's just one of them utility plastic sinks, and mount it to the wall. Now you got five sinks, and you're in sink heaven. You're a sinkinaire. Okay, it's like a millionaire, but different. So you have all these sinks. And a place to do it. Now you have your own commissary. Now, what do you do with that commissary? How do you make money with that commissary? Guess how many vendors, the whole reason I'm doing this video, don't want to go find a commissary, scared to death of finding a commissary. It's a once and done thing, by the way. You do it once, you're done. It's like registering your business or getting your tax number. Yeah, it's a pain in the butt sometimes. Some places it's harder than others. But then it's done. It's once and done. It's an investment. It's also what keeps half-butt people out of the business, because half-butters can't miss Jerry Springer reruns, and they ain't getting up from their Netflix, and they ain't about to start a business because they just found out I got a call and get a tax number. Are you kidding me? I ain't doing it. And so they don't become our competition. So there are some hoops you've got to jump through, but they're all worth it. It comes down to you do it once and you're done. Now, I got on a little rant there, and I lost track of where I was headed. So let me jump on this before I forget. Some people go, well, Ben, I have a food truck or a food trailer, and my health inspector says because I have a wash, rinse, sanitizer, and a hand wash sink in there, four sinks total, that I'm good to go. I don't need a commissary. Great. That ain't the state code. I can promise you. I've read every state's codes, all 50 states. It ain't in there. There's nothing in there that says you, because you have a food truck with four sinks, you can't, don't have to have a commissary. But I can take you right over to my next county over, Knox County, Tennessee, and find you an inspector right now who will accept the four little bitty sinks on a big dog cart as your commissary. That's your, oh, you got four sinks? You don't need a commissary then. You got four sinks. how the hell are you going to wash a 12 by 20 pan in that little bitty sink? You ain't going to. But they don't care. Sometimes you'll get an inspector who just doesn't care. That's how people get away from it. But I want to mention this while I mention that. Don't find out that Bob, your buddy, your new buddy, you just found Bob. Okay, this just happened to a vendor. Pissed me off. Okay? But your new found buddy, Bob, is over here, and you found out he doesn't have to have a commissary, and his inspector is letting him use chili and cheese, and he's allowed to have Danishes on his cart, and then you talk to your inspector, and your inspector goes, no, it says right here in the code, no Danishes, you can't have Danishes, and you go, well, Bob's got them. Bob's inspector lets him have it. Don't do that. That ain't going to help you. All it's going to do is hurt someone else. So don't be that guy, okay, or girl. Don't go, well, somebody else does, because that's like third grade mentality, and it doesn't get us anywhere. Okay, so don't throw anybody under the bus doing that crap. So let me explain this to you. So there are those vendors. I'm going to go back and forth here just for a bit. But there are those vendors that make their own commissary. Like Jason Brown created his own commissary. And guess what he does? He rents it out. How much does he rent it for? About $400 a month to multiple vendors. So it provides a whole nother income. That's how you do it. Lots of vendors are doing that. I got a buddy that's in right now in Georgia. He rented a building, put his own commissary in after vending for a while. I mean, it wasn't like the first day vending, he went out and got him a commissary and, you know, his own commissary. He finally made it to the point where he's doing good enough. He goes, you know what? I'm going to invest in a commissary. I'm going to put my own kitchen in. And then he rents it and he makes money. And I got a friend in Asheville, North Carolina, near the Black Mountain area, that's got a commissary. And he's had to add on to it twice because he's got so many vendors that are using it because they'll claim it even though they're 3 hours away. They'll claim that that's their commissary, okay? And they rent space from him. Some of them he never sees. And they have access to the kitchen to use it. And he's making more money doing that. He started out as a vendor. And then he built his own commissary. And then he started renting to other vendors. And now he doesn't even vend anymore. He just rents commissary space, okay? Nothing wrong with that. He found something he liked doing, and he likes doing that. And more power to him. So there is a lot of money to be made in a commissary, even though it's a hurdle to you in the beginning, or maybe, you know, it's a perceived hurdle. It's really not. Like, you know, I don't know if y'all, how long you've been following me, and some of you will remember this that have been following me a while, but there was a vendor, I believe it was in New Mexico, called up. You know, we had a hot dog radio show where you could actually call in, and you can listen to all those old ones. They're on iTunes. Just look up Hot Dog Vendor Radio. And called in and said, I can't get a commissary. Everybody's saying no. And I said, are you going in person? Yeah, I'm going in person. That's one of my rules. Go in person. Never go do it over the phone. It's easy to get a no over the phone, right? So anyway, this went back and forth. They called every week. Still can't find a commissary. The only thing stopping me is getting a commissary. Finally, it's a matter of timing. You know, as far as I don't have time to handhold and do this all for each person. So I try to just give broad information and help as many as I can. So I finally just gave up the ghost on this one and said, listen, okay, he got my red up. This is a basic deal. And I said, okay, here's the deal. Give me the people that you talked to who told you no. And he did. Not then. He emailed me later. I live recorded calling these people. I live recorded it, posted it up, okay? And I called these people he said he called. Two of them said they never heard of him, never saw him, nothing. What he assumed is that I wouldn't call him. Number one, he never went to nobody, okay? One guy did say, yes, I got a call from somebody, don't know if that's the person, but I did get a call last week from somebody that wanted to use my kitchen, and I told them no. And I said, well, let me ask you something. I said, I'm calling for Vendors United, and I'm trying to help a vendor out. They got a small family, and they're trying to get started, and the state is, this was in Texas, that's where it was, Texas. And I said, and the state of Texas requires the vendor to have a commercial kitchen. Not, and you probably won't ever see them, but all they're making sure is that they're washing the pans, you know, there. But you probably won't ever see them. And he goes, oh, I'd do that. So, the, like, worst case is they'll come by and wash a pan. And I said, yeah. And, you know, wash a few pans. And I said, yeah. And he goes, absolutely. Tell them to come back up here and see me. And that was done. And that was by the phone, which I hate doing by the phone. But it was just a fact that he just didn't want to do it. And I understand that. Not all of us have that. I'll walk up, you know the people are that just never meet a stranger. That's a great benefit, but not all vendors are the never meet a stranger type. So I get it. It can be, you know, scary and overwhelming to think, I got to go talk to the gas station about, that's going to sound ridiculous. No, it doesn't sound ridiculous. And I give you the script. I tell you what to say, and you can tweak that to be fit your personality, but the gist of it. So that's all you need to do. Commissaries are easy, okay? And yes, you can go buy one. You can go to the incubator kitchen site, and you can just look up your state and rent one for $350 a month or $900 a month. Some states are ridiculous. So anyway, you can get around having to ask anybody, but for $600 a month or $350 a month, I'd take a free one, wouldn't you? All right, so let me look at questions, and then we'll, I want to see if I have questions here. And I may do these out of order. I'm going to start at the bottom instead of the top. Okay. Look, Fred West says, cool, I made it to a live video. Eerie Vibes, or Eerie Vibes. I messed that up yesterday. I'm going to just go with Eerie, and you correct me if I'm wrong. Eerie Vibes, good luck. Byron, pray you find one today. Byron, I'm actually out driving around now looking for a commissary. I may have should have done these in the other order because that didn't make sense, did it? So Byron said that, and then Eerie Vibes says, good luck to Byron. So I'm actually out driving around looking for a commissary. I have no shame. I will be asking everyone today until I get one. You know what? It won't take long, Byron. It's pretty easy. And you will. You will. And I love your attitude. Tom's in the house. Tom Eaton. Eating food again. I love that name. It's a great play on words. And you notice what he says? If you notice a lot of these vendors, they're smart. They got and catering. There's a reason. Tom says, title has me intrigued. Okay. Cindy, newbie on the block here. I'm glad you're here, Cindy. Let's see. I just read that one. Howdy, it's snowing here. Now, remember this. If you're new and you're looking into this business, I have set up vendors that you can go vend with for free, and I'll even, just to help you, pay for your trip, basically. I'll pay up to $300 if you end up buying a car from me. If you don't, it's still free, okay? So you go for free. Well, how do you do that? You go to learnhotdogs.com/, and somebody, if you don't mind, put this in the chat comments, learnhotdogs.com/best day ever, all together, best day ever. Okay. Learnhotdogs.com/best day ever. You can pick a vendor, go spend the day with them, feel it, see if you like it before you do it. Okay. These vendors do this out of the kindness of their hearts. They're on my list of vendors that are willing to do it, and they'll schedule you in. Some are busier than others, and you will get an experience of a life. And at least you'll be able to say, you know what? I like this. Or you know what? I hate this. And that's before you spend a dime. 80 degrees Fahrenheit here in Jacksonville, Florida, Dan says. That's hot. We got another Jacksonville, Florida person here in the house. I saw her pop up. She's in our Vendors United group. And she's got a cart coming her way soon. Let's see. Look here, Jim Kitts, a new friend of mine. He's in Corytown, Tennessee, just got started, retired police officer, retired, I think, sheriff deputy, or sheriff sergeant, he's something. He was law enforcement for a long time. Good guy, has a, just got started last week, found a used car and is going at it. And I can't wait to watch his success continue to grow. Thanks for being here, Jim. That's Popo Hot Dogs. You know what they say? That's the Popo. Let's see. There's the look. Look, I was just talking about the other vendor in Vendors United. That's Shannon. And she's in Jacksonville. Audacious Dogs, about to get up and running. Let's see. Where are all these thingy jiggers? Y'all have to bear with me. My screen, I'm going to have to plug something in or do something here. Because for some reason... Well, that didn't... I had this set to save the chat. It's not saving the chat for whatever reason. It's just my luck. I like it when it saves the chat so y'all have a... If somebody's going back, they can see what I'm talking about. Look at that. We designed the kiosk with everything, Joe says, and we met the requirements. Mobile food vendor, didn't think so, something more. Let's see. Anybody here use Venmo? Absolutely, I use Venmo every time my daughter say, Dad, I need some money, I Venmo it to them. Rent your commissary. John, great question. This goes back to our question. John says, how much do you rent your commissary for? Well, different vendors are renting for different prices, but it's all your market. So if your market is a great area and you're seeing a lot of vendors come in, that is perfect. That's ripe for charging $400 or $500, $600. I told you, I've seen up as high as $900. Do you need to be that high? No, I wouldn't try to take advantage of people. But if they don't want to go get their own commissary for free, then by all means, charge something. It's you're taking the risk. They're using your kitchen, okay, your commercial kitchen. Me personally, if I was starting today about anywhere, I'd charge about $350 a month or $400 a month, somewhere in that range. That's fair. That's affordable. And it would give them access. Now, as you add more features in your commissary, well, then by all means, raise the price. Because if you start putting deep fryers in, hood systems, dough rising machines, and all that stuff, yeah, raise the price. Because some of these vendors that I have met and talked with have built their commissary and then expanded their commissary, like the boy in Asheville. And now rents commissary by the hour to let's say, Mabel, who makes the best biscuits in the world with her cinnamon raisin biscuits, but she can't sell them because she doesn't have a commissary. Well, Mabel goes in for an hour and makes her biscuits at the commissary, and now she can sell them at the stores because under the Cottage Industry Act, which I have a video on that if I'm confusing anybody, but anyway, she can go out and sell now because of that, because she made it in a commercial kitchen, and it only cost her an hour. She didn't have to rent it for the month, but the vendor who's the business owner that's doing that is getting to make more money that way. Because it's by the hour, for obvious reasons, right? Shannon says she's so excited about her cart. I'm excited for them. They're going to kick butt. Jacksonville is ripe. You can make a lot of money in Jacksonville. I've done a handful of events in Jacksonville. Drove all the way from Tennessee with my big dog. And done some, I did it at, I've done at St. Augustine, and I've done on the Riverwalk there in downtown Jacksonville. Seems a grease trap is a huge deal. Yes, some states are. I have a friend that's doing a commissary right now in the state of Florida, and he's somewhere near Gainesville, okay? And they're requiring that grease trap. Well, he finally found one online that he could put in that's pretty cheap. It was $150. And that is a trap, so your dirty water, your gray water, runs out of the sinks, and then it goes through these little baffles that prevents the grease from going into the city sewer system, and it traps the grease. So every so often, you have to open this lid, unscrew it, take that apart, and go dump that grease into a approved grease disposal tank, who somebody will pay you for. Like, they'll pay you to pick that tank up. They'll pay you for your used grease because they use it to recycle. Ben, where do you get the hat? I bought this hat about 3 years ago. I was up in Pennsylvania, at Skipback, Pennsylvania, at the Tractor Supply Store in Pennsylvania. And since then, I have worn this hat out. It's pretty crappy condition. If you could really see it, you'd go, what is he, why is he wearing that? I love it because it's comfortable. And it's really cool on my head as far as it lets air in. Well, I've bought more, and they were none the same, even though they were the same model number and everything. So go figure. Maybe they quit making it, but I think you could still find it. I bought my last one on Amazon, and it's in my pickup truck. Let's see. What up, dog? Off today due to blizzard warning. There, I was talking about this in the Midwest, right? Rue says the blizzard warning, and they are. Holy crap, they're getting a storm in the Midwest right now today. I wouldn't be vending in it either, Ruth. Yeah, scarecrow hat, Sam. You're right. Anyway, that's it. That's it. I hope that answers your questions on commissaries. I hope you feel more confident. I hope if you had hesitations, now you see the opportunities that commissaries can be. And I will be happy to help. I have some unanswered comments on YouTube. Believe it or not, I'm a little behind, just a day or two. And if there's questions in there, if you've got questions, please ask, and I'll try to do a video on it. Okay, I'll try to come back or cover multiple topics in one video. But this one was all about commissaries, and I think I nailed the commissaries. I hope that helps you. I gave you the free way to get them and multiple ways to get free ones. If you need further help on commissaries, learnhotdogs.com. Type in the search box the word commissary, and you will be eaten up, just like Tom Eaton, eaten up with commissary tips, tricks, hacks, my script, places to get them, how to get them, all for free. Okay? So do that. I love you. I'll talk to you soon. Bye.